हमारे अगले इसमें इनकॉर्पोरेट करने की कोशिश करेंगे। धन्यवाद बद्रीनाथ जी। अभी मैं अगले स्पीकर श्री दीपेंद्र नाथ दास जी को अनुरोध करता हूँ कि वह अपने विचार इस बारे में आपके सामने रखे। श्री दीपेंद्र नाथ दास जी।
Regards to all the co-panelists in the dais and all my colleagues and friends in the audience, I got chance actually to go through the report. I'm happy that the report is very, very concise and it has tried to incorporate all the issues, though it has not been able to elaborate, and if it had been elaborated, I think it could have gone more than 1,000 pages. So within less than 200 pages it has tried to, but the major issues whatever are very, very relevant, those have been covered. And I am happy because I am a very keen student of population studies, and some of my colleagues are also here, and we know that in India 2-3 institutions are there which are very, very famous and doing effective research on population, that International Institute of Population Science in Mumbai, and in our JNU, the Center for the Study of Regional Development, they are also effectively participating in population studies. So when we talk about the data issues, it has come up actually, and it is very difficult to think that how to capture the data, because several issues are there. When we talk about migration, and the migration data and other than migration data, there is a huge difference. That in demography, we usually take several sorts of data. The migration data, characteristically, it is a flow data. When we talk about the flow data, then it becomes very, very complex. When it is event data, if we take about the birth, death, then skill or the occupation, any sorts of things actually, so those data are different than the flow data. As soon as we are saying the flow data, so the complexity rises, as people have thought of that it has a source, it has a destination. In the process of from source to destination, there is a time, and each and every moment actually, it is creating certain phase which can also be a data. And I am really puzzled actually, that many people, those who are dealing with the migration issues, there are very little expertise to understand the phenomena of migration. And I started my career with the work in Census of India, Ministry of Home Affairs. For more than 6 years, I served there. And I have seen actually the people, those who are working, even the higher authority, those who are dealing with the issues, they think that the administrative part is very, very important, but the academic part or the issues of the data, I am sorry to say that many people do not actually understand. And when they do not understand it, then the things become very, very mechanical, as it has been prescribed, without understanding the objective, without understanding the further usage of the data, some things are being collected and produced and disseminated for the users. And the effect of it, the way we get it, many a times the things are not. So, very, very effective, those who understand the issues, those who can give effective suggestions to the complexities, those sorts of people in the involvement of creation of the data is little actually. Sometimes we think that the great economist or great statistician, if we want, and just giving the messaging of the data or with certain estimations and certain manipulations, we can give the correct figure. Many a times it is not possible because the origin of the data itself is not understood properly, and the way it has been captured, whatever we make, that will not be fruitful. Many a times our studies are not becoming fruitful or effective in the phases of implementation because of that problem. The data issues have been raised a time and again in several chapters of this report. I am not going in a very structured way. I had gone through the step by step and I took out the points the report has highlighted. I like to discuss all these things. So data is a very, very complex issue, and the expertise to understand the data and how it is being created and what are the complexities, what are the objectives for which we like to capture the data, and keeping the implementation problems actually, those aspects also to be in the data collection process. Otherwise, the published data is very, very difficult to, even the data whatever census collect is not having so much of complexities. We know 2011 data related to migration, it has come 2018. Maybe some other issues are there. And always we have seen that census takes 5, 6, 7 years, even after full digital capturing of the data and publication, it took a lot of time because many issues are there. Now, if we see the pattern of migration, the report has captured very well, actually, particularly Krishna Rao, he has given that we have seen the visual of the migration when during the COVID, how it had happened, actually. Academically, we used to discuss from this state to this state, it is going, this is the flow, this is the test strength of flow, this is the level. So, source, destination, many analyses were there. But if we think that during COVID, it had given a kind of portrayal how the things are happening. We have seen that a huge flow of migration are coming from the west, they're moving towards the east, or the huge flow of migration coming from south, they are also trying to converge towards the east in the states of Uttar Pradesh, in the states of Bihar, Jharkhand, West Bengal, Assam, and the portrayal of their things of what they have faced the problems in their transition from one place to destination to source. So the thing has given us a very important thing to understand why it is happening. We have seen that Maharashtra, Gujarat, or Tamil Nadu, Karnataka, Kerala, partly Haryana, Punjab, these are the states which are receiving migrants from these actually source areas, and they are going actually. So the important thing, many a time we think that the certain words are being pronounced by our government, and this is a kind of popular words or buzzword. It's not like this. Migrant, this migration portrayal has given us the feelings that look east policy. When our Prime Minister says the look east policy is very, very important actually. And see the areas, Uttar Pradesh, Bihar, West Bengal, Assam, whole actually eastern side is really actually a problem. If we think that our human body is like of our country actually, then if we think that my right hand or left hand or some fingers of my legs are not working, then I cannot get the full efficiency of my body for the development. So keeping a part actually which is not moving at the same space, the way our Indian development trajectory is moving, then it's not possible to achieve our objective that we want to have a very, very respectable and commanding position in the global order. It's very, very difficult. And it is very problematic to think that when we talk about the state of Uttar Pradesh, that we say that political nucleation is in Uttar Pradesh. It has given so many prime ministers. Even if you see the Raibareli, one of the poorest district of Uttar Pradesh, why has it happened so? 6, 7 prime ministers have come from that state. Then we are not asking why this problem is happening. Bihar, it has actually pumped so many migrants all over the India. But still, if we see that they should have done it, like UK, if we think about the 17th century, 18th century, it went out all over the world, and today their GDP is very, very negative, but it's a very, very rich country. Why it has happened actually? Accumulating so many resources from several parts, they have also contributed in the homeland. But what is the problem of Uttar Pradesh, Bihar? They have pumped actually so many migrants all over the country, but still in their origin, it's really pathetic. We need to see it actually. Certain
political, certain social, certain economic aspects are there, in spite of having so much control over the democracy and so much participation in the all the decision-making program, why the problems are coming up. So the attitudinal and other things, we need to think it, and particularly the Lukist policy, it should be, few days ago our Home Minister had visited West Bengal, though there is no chapter in West Bengal in the study, but I thought that it would have been very fruitful to take West Bengal situations, because now West Bengal is also giving certain replications, what is happening in other states, and we think that the problems in those states are also actually in terms of share of the India's burden is huge. If we can solve the problems of UP and Bihar, Jharkhand, West Bengal, I think 60-70% problem of the country will be solved. And what he was talking, that we need a kind of ecosystem for the development. And we cannot just pinpoint that we need to take up the issues of the migrants, we need to take up the issues of the agricultural labor, we need to take up the issues of the informal sector. It's not like that. And as I told, that it is a system, and all the systems are actually related to each other, and everything has to move in together in coordination of each and ingredients and the aspects of development. So all the aspects should actually, and there he talked about many things actually. He talked about agriculture and MSME, then the return migrant and MSME, and the industry and agriculture, and agriculture, industry, and the world trade, and the geopolitical relationship. And it was really fabulous, I was seeing actually. And he told within 2-3 minutes in terms of answering to the questions of the journalists, he just told 2-3 minutes that we need to have a kind of ecosystem of development, not the things we have to do it in a piecemeal basis. And one of the very important thing is that the COVID has given us the lessons that taking a huge part of Uttar Pradesh, Bihar, Jharkhand, Orissa, West Bengal, Assam and whole Northeast actually will not be able to resolve a lot of problems of the country. That in 70s, 80s and part of 90s, when we were student, we used to think of that Bimaru Bimaru. Professor Ashish Bose had coined that terminology, and we are bogged down with that thing. Actually, so it used to say that UP, Bihar, Rajasthan, Madhya Pradesh, these are the culprits of the problem of underdevelopment. It's not actually. This thing has shifted. Now the problem has actually gone far deeper towards the east, and it has made a kind of blind alley. And the report has pointed it out. I am happy that though it has not given much of the elaborations, but suddenly it has winked at that problems, and it has given the clue that in national level we need to see the geographically, these are the areas geographically. Now what are the aspects in those geographical areas we need to take it up? Those are obviously political aspects, is very, very important. Whenever we try to do anything, as it was being stated, the data, that the digitization of the data is very, very important. When government says that this is our objective and we like to have the digital thing, then you will find that so many far and row is there, that how to actually make it failure, that it should not happen. If you say a unified ID card, if he says that that portable voter card or portable PDF card, actually ration card, then Aadhaar card, where everywhere, why so much of tussles are there? Then one feeling actually gives me that the objective is to have the betterment of our development and give a very, very good livelihood to each and every citizen of the country. Then why the objections is there? Are we doing certain corrupt practice? Are we afraid of doing certain malafide and things which are not permissible by the society and the state? Then if those are not there, why the resistance are there? And a lot of resource, energy and efforts are going in waste just to counter all these things actually. If you see it, and those who are in the implementations of the policies and programs, they will find that objectives are very, very good, resources are also, there is no doubt, but problem is that there are so many bottlenecks in terms of resistance which are useless actually, and how to counter them. That in a democratic system you cannot tell that I am giving the whip, you must have to accept it, it's not possible. But at the same time we find that though whatever are being said, that you can raise a question, that you might have certain bad intentions, you might have certain problems of getting choked, that you will not be able to practice your corruption deals, or it will be curbing the criminal activities. So in data problem, when we talk about the digital thing, those problems are there. And migration is coming in a, I'm afraid actually, I will try to concise as, so it has come that six pillar, as it has told in the report, actually all the economy, infrastructure, technology, demographic skill or dividends, along with the demands, the sixth pillar can be migration. It's no doubt actually. Now we are in the age where the migration and urbanization already we have accepted, this is contributing to the huge percentage of, to our GDP, more than 60% GDP is coming from urbanization. But thing is that we can also give a lot of pump to our agriculture and make a kind of balance, that how the agricultural things has gone down in terms of its contribution to the GDP. It's not that that urban is very, very good and it's a very, very value-adding and effective sectors of engine of development. It's not like that actually. We have neglected a lot to the agricultural sectors. See, after the Green Revolution, whatever we have got a bumper in the crop productions, then we have not tried to diversify the crop production. Problem is that certain crops which are coming at a very, very high level, we know that what the nutrition purpose, those are there, but we need to have the diversification of the crop so that we can make a balance between the demand and supply. And there are certain crops actually which can be used not only in the country for the making agricultural sector very dynamic, but also grab certain global market. What China is doing actually, they have diversified it apart from the food grains, and therefore now another problem is that in agriculture, APMC actually, if it is not possible to actually go away from APMC, we need to have certain control, like industrial goods, wherever you go. And even we had visited the remote parts of the Ladakh, then we, in 90s and even in some first decades of 2000, that some industrial, even rein product or certain potato chips, you can find it there. But certain agricultural goods, you don't find that within the state, not only within the district, it is stuck. So the way it has been proposed, so many misinformations are there. To make agriculture sector very dynamic, it's very effective, whatever the producers are coming, it is not on the producers of that particular block or the district or the state, but it is the producers for the country as a whole, but also it is the producers for the global market also. And from there, we need to make a little bit of flexibility in APMC, or if it's not possible to go away totally from it, that sector should be, and the farmers and agricultural people should be made understood that whatever they are doing and they are producing, those are very, very valuable. Since it is not linked or they are not in position. I am coming from West Bengal, and we have seen actually since my childhood that in 80s, 90s, that they huge bumper crop productions of potatoes. And many a times the prices of the produce thing is so low, they even do not harvest. The cost of harvesting of potato becomes much larger than the product they usually get after selling. Why it is so? And it is happening. And years after years actually, decades after decades. And we need to actually, in the beginning there may be certain problems, and now we have come up actually when we say that even a rickshawpuller, even a maid, they are having digital devices in their hand. Through those digital devices, they can connect themselves with the state and national market, even with the international market. So if there are certain systems, the integrating even the local with the national, state and international market, then whatever you are producing, you will not think that next door neighbor or the local market don't have the demand of it, therefore we should not go for it. So
So that agricultural sector is needed to be actually made very, very dynamic. The production, whatever it is happening, that some farm laws has come, those are very effective, but we know that stalemate has come because of the, just for the purpose of opposition, it is being opposed. Whatever the problems are, that those if are rectified, then we need to make the system of the market, we need to take the idea of the diversifications of the producers, whatever is being done in the agricultural system, then we can get the whoever are coming back. If we know that push-pull factor in migration, we talk about why people are going from UP, Bihar, even from nowadays after 80s from West Bengal. West Bengal was a very rich state. It had almost 30% of the India's GDP in 1960s, and if we consider now, it is having 2-3% to that GDP of whatever we had in 1960s. And now it has become a state, like I'm not telling, actually it is giving the supply to the rickshaw puller, supplies to the maid servant, supplies to the domestic, though it is giving a minimum that skilled laborers. So all the states actually, all the, we told that the, those who are the destinations, Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, Kerala, Maharashtra, Gujarat, they are very efficient. They are also migrating from one place to another place, and very skilled labor they are giving. But they are receiving very, very underdeveloped, unskilled laborers. And from those areas, we need to see that pattern, and those things are to be made. And destination, whatever the problems they are creating in the sorry source, that can be handled in a very, very. And we know that agricultural sector is a sector where huge disguised unemployment is there. And we do, that agricultural sector is not getting their wages, because those who are in economics, Professor Santosh Mehrotra is there, I am encroaching a little bit, that the wages is determined with the marginal productivity of the laborers engaged in that sector. But many a times it is seen that agricultural productivity of the marginal laborers is almost zero. And though there is an average positivity in the production, but productivity, but many a times that marginal. And they get with the average prices of the livelihood in that area. So if your livelihood is very, very poor, if you can manage with 2,000, 3,000, on that basis your wage rate is determined. And that we cannot expect. When you mix with the national and global order, then you find that the problem of inequity, inequality, it all are coming. Unless you connect yourself with the global order, make the agricultural sector vibrant, it will be very, very difficult to check the problems. The returned migrants have gone, they have a huge skill, the government has given huge chances of MSME. And just for an example, I am telling that so many workers from West Bengal, from Hooghly, Howrah, then Chobbish Pargana, from Midnapur, they usually go in different parts of Mumbai, Delhi, even Gujarat, and they usually do the works related to jewelry, ornamentations, and all these things. They have come back. They are very efficient labor. If MSME is giving something to them, they can be there itself, and if the market is linked, and they can also be actually those areas be have for the global market. So now MSME has given a huge chance actually to explore all the things, and the report has given very good to actually coverage of all the things. And I'm afraid he's writing something, he will be telling. Restrict with the time. So before we hand over the chip to me, but I have seen the report is really fabulous. It has touched upon all the important issues, but the intricacies and the complexities, it has not gone. Might be they have thought of that they need to restrict it within certain pages. Therefore, I told that we have a huge resources within the report, and from there, just attaching with the mind and emotions with the reports, if we give the prescriptions to the government, and honestly, if the government takes it up, really, we can have a very, very good country, and a country which can have a command over the globe. Thank you so much.
धन्यवाद दीपेंद्रनाथ जी, आपके हार्ट फेल्ट कॉमेंट्स हमारे रिपोर्ट के ऊपर जो आई है वो डेफिनेटली सराहनीय है, उसका उपयोग हम डेफिनेटली करेंगे। मगर टाइम कंस्टेंट के कारण यहाँ एक्चुअली पैनल डिस्कशन के लिए रखना था, मगर अभी 1 बजने जा रहा है और हमारा टाइम खत्म होने जा रहा है, इसलिए मैं श्री एस के मेहरोत्रा जी को अनुरोध करता हूँ कि वो इस पैनल डिस्कशन का कंक्लूजन करें। श्री एस के मेहरोत्रा जी,
धन्यवाद हरि जी, धन्यवाद प्रमोद जी, माननीय सुनील जी आम्बेकर, बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद मुझे यहाँ आमंत्रित करने के लिए। सबसे पहले तो मैं अपने साथियों को जिन्होंने ये रिपोर्ट लिखी है उनको बधाई देना चाहता हूँ, डॉक्टर रावल को,